Today we're going to talk about first 1,000 days and nutrition. First 1,000 days, what is first 1,000 days? I'm sure we all know it, but just, I'm going to reiterate why it is important. And when we think of first 1,000 days, forget about other children. Let's talk about us, right? A lot of us are women, men, and, some of you are very young and probably thinking of future of having children and, thinking about their growth and their, their career. So when we think of that, we always think of short-term goal and long-term goal. So what is our short and long-term goal for children? Not only children, but for ourselves. So, obviously in short term, we want our children to be healthy. We want them to be doing well in school and, succeed, of course. And in long term, we want them not to have any diseases, to have good immunity, no blood pressure, no diabetes. And of course, we all want healthy aging for all of us, right? That's our long and short term goal by and large, right? So basically health comes first, right? Health is wealth. As we all are stuck at home because our health is at stake. So if we don't have good health, nothing else matters really. So literally our goal is to have lifelong health, right? Why first 1,000 days critical? We need to kind of understand why is it critical? Why those 1,000 days, So first 1,000 days is basically conception to second birthday of the child, and it offers the opportunity to build healthier and more prosperous future, as good nutrition during this phase gives building block for brain and physical development. Okay, so what is happening during this 1,000 days is baby's brain has been developed. Okay, not only baby's brain is being developed, but basically there is a full physical growth. Can you imagine from small little ovum from sperm and that ovum you're having, and birth weight is about 3 kg, and by the time child is about two years of age, almost 12 kg, 12.5 kg, right? So you have tremendous growth in this first 1,000 days, and not only physical growth but brain. Brain is the most important part of our body, right? So it's very important that we take care of this 1,000 days. Okay, if you want a brainy child, and if you want a really healthy, robust child, and if you look at the growth, brain grows to about 80% of adult size, okay, by age 3, and it reaches 90% by age 5. So by the time child goes to school, say around 4.5, 5 years of age, 90% of brain development has already taken place. So you can imagine that mother needs to know so much, right? Not only when she's pregnant, but even before she is pregnant, she needs to know what I need to do so that my child will be tall and intelligent, right? And what are the right nutrients that she needs? Okay, and those are very important, because and those are needed at the right time, because child's brain is developing so fast, and at every stage child requires different micronutrients. So it is important, and we'll talk about it, what is required. Okay, so the right nutrition during this period, it means the difference between a life of productivity or struggle and between life and death. We work in tribal areas, we work in slums, and most of the time you will see that SAM children, you must be knowing SAM, severe acute malnourished children, those are mainly under 1 year of age, under 2 years of age, mainly under 1 year of age, and even predominantly they are less than 6 months of age. So if you don't have proper nutrition during first 1,000 days, that's basically that, that's you're taking away life from that child, literally. Okay, and at that child, if suppose child is survived, and if child grows up, but the body is so stunted, and with that body the child's brain is stunted, so basically that child will struggle for the whole life to survive. Okay, just not life and death in the beginning, but if child survives, basically they will have a child will have a very poor productivity, not only in school but even when he grows up. So it's important that we think of not only surviving the child but also giving him good life. So what does it decide? It decides how healthy the child will be. So less infection, better immunity, reduce risk of chronic condition like diabetes and blood pressure. How brainy the child will be. What do you mean by brainy? So brainy means you have good cognition, means intelligence, your memory. So child has a sharp memory. We all want, right? Like, believe me, all your mothers must be asking you, what grades did you get? How many marks did you get? Did you come first? Did you come second? And for that, for everything to learn, not only you need intelligence, but what else do you need? You need memory, right? So this is important, that why some children in a class, they remember everything, and some children, they just don't remember anything. So that's important to have a good memory. Concentration. If you can't concentrate, that means you will not be able to do well, you know. So it's very important that child have a good concentration. Judgment, we all know what is judgment, whether something a child is doing, taking decision, whether it's, you know, taking good judgmental call. Those are very important. Mood is important. Sometimes you find the children are very moody. They're upset. They're all the time irritable. So your mood also depends upon how child was brought up in the first 1,000 days. Okay. And then lastly, your skeletal growth, how tall the child will be. So these are the three important aspects that we need to take care of when child is growing in first 1,000 days. So let's talk about brain. Brain is my favorite topic. So I'm going to talk about brain a little bit and see how we can make this child intelligent. Okay. So yeah, I'm sure you guys know about neural tube. This is basically a tube. Here, this is the picture. So this is your neural tube. Okay. So at around 3 weeks of age, your body starts developing in the form of neural tube. So this is a tube. Okay. Now here, this part is basically is going to develop into brain, and this part is going to develop into your spinal cord. Okay. So here, then what happens during this time? Suppose if you don't have enough nutrients which are required for this neural growth, you will have problems. So what are the micronutrients which are required for development of this neural tube? One is your folic acid. I think everybody knows about folic acid. But what we don't know, there are 2-3 other micronutrients which are required for a neural tube neural tube development. One is your vitamin B12. The second is your choline. So you require just choline, vitamin B12 and folic acid. So we only talk about folic acid, but how about B12 and your, I know that a lot of you are nutritionists, and we know that B12 is hardly available in any vegetarian food. So what are you going to tell mother who is not even having milk? Like, for example, a lot of these tribal mothers, they don't drink milk. They don't have access to milk. So how will she get B12? Right, so we have to think of what nutrients that she, or what all food that you can give them, so they'll have initially. I mean, this is 3 weeks, so she doesn't even know that she's pregnant, right? So you need to start this nutrients not when she's pregnant, but when she gets married, or when she's planning a child. That's when you need to start food which is high in all these nutrients. I'll talk about choline later. Now, when you don't have this most three important micronutrients for neural tube, what will happen? This tube will not develop well. So do you see these tubes? These are not, basically, you will see the gap in there. Okay, so this is all the gap, and this is called neural tube defect. This is a tube, neural tube. This is a neural tube defects. Okay, so then what happens when you have a neural tube defect, say posteriorly, like towards the lower part, right? Then you will have a little bit of spinal cord coming out. Okay, because the spinal canal is not developed well, right? So then what happens is that basically you will see some amount of spinal cord here. Now, many times what happens, you may not have such a big bump over here, but you may just have a little bit of hole, tiny, tiny hole over here. Okay, so what as pediatrician we have to do? We always have to examine when the baby is born, if the child has little hole, and if child has a hole, that means it's called basically spina bifida, and we have to get the MRI done. And that particular hole, if it is worse, then child has paralysis for the whole life. Okay, they have problem with the urination. They have to go through surgery. So imagine folic acid, choline, and your B12 is so important. Okay, and if child has hole in the front part, you know, right where their brain is, then this is called an encephaly. Okay, we nowadays we don't see it much, but you know, they do have when they're born. Obviously, they don't survive. So this is all basically totally, you know, you can prevent all this condition. And that's why folic acid has been done compulsory. Okay, now this is basically anatomy of brain. Now I'm going to go a little bit in detail that what happens in child's brain when the brain is developing. Okay, so these are basically different parts of your brain. This is the frontal cortex, frontal part, front of your brain. This is the back part. Okay, this is your side part, parietal. This is your occipital lobe, temporal lobe. These are all different kind of lobes, right? This is a cross section. This is a cross section, right? This is a front part. This is a back part. So if you look at it over here, so this is again, you know, your prefrontal cortex, right? Your primary motor cortex. These are all the different parts of your brain. Okay, now if you look at the function of brain, so here is your front part of your brain. Okay, so do you see over here, this is this particular frontal part, it is involved in motivation and executive function. Motivation, if you don't have motivation to do anything, you can't, you know, you can't succeed, right? So it's very important that this part of brain is developed well, because it is it functions for execution and for motivation. Okay, now a little bit about the anterior cingulate cortex over here, this part over here, that is involved in your social interaction, affection, attention. So look at this. This part is also so important because that will help with the attention, right? Do you see over this red part over here? It's called amygdala. Amygdala is important for stress and for learning. So a lot of time what happens is, you know, lots of children, they get a lot of anxiety, stress, you know, or they have learning problem. That is because of problem with amygdala. And this is your hippocampus. Hippocampus, remember, is for learning and memory. If you want good memory, you make sure that anything which is required to develop this hippocampus, you work on that and, you know, child will have good memory. Okay, so this are your basically brain development. So at fourth week of pregnancy, the brain has about 10,000 cells. Okay, and by 24th week, it contains about 10 billion. So you can imagine in just matter of 20 weeks, look at the number of cells being developed, right? So nutrition is absolutely important, but there are so many other things which are important. Okay, this is your neurons. Do you see all these neurons? These are basically connection. So as brain is developing, neuron cells are developing. And do you see this layer of, you know, myelin sheet? This is called myelin sheet. Now, myelin sheet is your fat. It's made up of fat. So when you have a good myelin, strong myelin sheet, what happens? The message passing through is very fast. The message, the signal, neural signals, those are very rapid signals, right? So you want to make sure that when mother is pregnant, that she gets good amount of fat, okay? Because baby's brain is made up of fat. This is all basically, it's all fatty sheet, right? And most important, cholesterol is important. Saturated fat is really important. This is your, what is this? Neurotransmitters. Remember your synapses. These are synaptic junctions, and there are your neurotransmitters. So neurotransmitters are also really, really important, basically to pass on the signal, right? So you want to make sure that you have to learn that which are these nutrients which are important for formation of neurotransmitter. One of the neurotransmitters is acetylcholine. If you remember acetylcholine, now choline, remember choline I spoke about? So we need to know how do this mother get choline so that a baby gets beautiful amount of neurotransmitters. Okay, now this is another beautiful graph. What we have shown over here, this is basically from conception, from 9 months to birth. Okay, this is your first 2 years of life. So from this are first 1,000 days, in this green box is first 1,000 days. Then here is your child growing up, becoming adult, and this is your 70 years of, so that's your basically, you know, your lifespan, right? So if here at around say 8 months of age, after 1 month of pregnancy, your child develop neurulation. Here that means that child is developing neural tube. Okay, once a neural tube is developed here, for next few months, it causes cell migration, means different parts of the brain are being formed, frontal lobe, occipital lobe, right? And then just before 2 months of birth, child start developing myelination. Myelination means, you know, you saw those neurons, right? So it start developing that myelin sheet around those neural cells. So if you look at around 0 month at birth, you know, some of the myelination has already started. You see all this? There are some amount of myelination already started, but then it starts picking up. So if you look at birth over here, the the green color graph over here, you know, so that is mainly your, so when the baby is born, what does baby do, right? Baby can see, baby can hear, right? So those parts of your brain is getting myelinated. You're seeing, hearing, so visual cortex is for seeing and auditory cortex is for hearing, okay? So those parts of your brain start getting myelination, right? Then if you look at your orange graph, this peaks at around 8 to 9 months of age. Do you see around 9 months of age? So what happens at 9 months of age? Do you remember what happens in the child? They start developing language. So they'll start speaking a word or two. So there is a receptive language. They can understand what you're saying. Okay. And they can also start producing speech. They'll say mama, dada, they'll say a word. So at around 9 months of age, that area get myelinated. You know, these are the areas of brain. Okay. And this one, the last line, the red line, that is yet around 12 months to 1 year of age, and that is your higher cognition. So by 1 year of age, 2 years of age, children have good amount of higher cognition function. You know, they can understand what you're saying, they can respond, you know, they become extremely smart. So do you see what this is the most important part? And after 2 years of age, you can see myelination going down. But it is very important that child continues to have good nutrition. Otherwise, what will happen if we get myelination problem, we will have a cognition issue. Means we will forget, we will have a forgetting, our memory will get worse. So it's important that we take care of our myelination. Okay. So this two, as you could see, 1,000 days are extremely important for brain development. Okay. Now, what are the other external factors which affects? As I told you, nutrition is good, but because there's you know, a lot of these neural cells are developing, you want to make sure that there is reduction of toxic stress in mothers. Okay. So tomorrow, if you're planning to become, you know, when you get married and plan to become pregnant, you make sure that you don't have stress, you know, you don't have any inflammation in the body. So you want to make sure that, you know, you don't have any diseases. Okay, and of course, presence of strong social support and secure attachment, very important. Okay, so just make sure those are physical health is absolutely important, but your mental health is also important, and provision of optimal nutrition. Okay, now these are some of the nutrients which are required for brain development. Okay, so I'm going to go quickly because I'll come back to it, but mainly look at it. This is vitamin B6. What happens when you don't have vitamin B6? In fact, those are important for brain development function. Those are important for neurotransmitters. You know, we talked about acetylcholine, but also, you know, your serotonin and so many other neurotransmitters. Okay, they norepinephrine, which also influences mood. And if you don't have B6, there are chances the child can have difficulty concentrating. Okay, then B12. As I talked about B12, right, neural tube defect. Okay, then poor cognition, if child doesn't have B12 when baby is growing in the womb, you know, they will have poor cognition. In younger children, in fact, what we find is children have tremors, children can have lifelong neurological problem. So it's important that, you know, we always think of vitamin B12 because this is quite deficient in the vegan children. Okay, mothers who are vegan. Choline, I spoke about. If you want your child to have a lifelong good memory and learning function, make sure the child gets, mothers get enough choline. Okay, copper is important. Folate, we talked about. Folate is important. We also talked about iodine. I think iodine is important because iodine can prevent mental retardation. You know, long chain polyunsaturated fatty acids. So mainly I'm talking about DHA and EPA. Okay. ALA can get converted to DHA, which I'll come back later, but it's the, you know, it's probably a 4% to maximum 10% get, you know, converted. So if mother is non-veg, please offer her fatty fish. Okay. That will really help child to become really, look at this. If you don't have enough DHA, then there is poor attention, hyperactivity, problem learning, right? So DHA EPA is extremely important. Protein is important, selenium, zinc, right? Why zinc? Look at this. Remember hippocampus I talked about? Memory. You want your child to have good memory. Your zinc is really important, okay? Vitamin K, we give it at birth. That's compulsory. We give it all over the world because children don't have enough vitamin K. So we give injection at birth. Okay, and iron is one topic that we can talk about for hours, really. It's so important. You know, it impacts myelination of nerves. Okay, and we have also found there are a lot of studies which says that the children have, if they don't have enough iron, it does affect their mental health, you know, so they have high level anxiety and depression later in life. So it's important that, you know, we take care of food which is high in iron. Okay, now this is some of the studies that I wanted to talk about. So one of the study is what is the influence of prenatal and postnatal growth on intellectual functioning? Because we all want our children to be intelligent, right? So what they found, actually, I love the study, really. So what they found that when child had beautiful linear growth, linear means tall, right? So when the child was growing quite tall in first year of age, before, not after, before 12 months of age, and weight. So this was the length part. Before 12, and the weight of the child before 4 months of age, if child was growing beautifully in first 4 months weight-wise and height up to 12 months of age, those children had a higher IQ at 9 years of age. Okay, so you can imagine many times, you know, mothers said, oh, my child is not gaining weight, my child is not gaining weight. And if we don't do anything right away, then if you miss those first 3 months of you know, weight gain, where, you know, children though grow tremendously, you know, when you look at a WHO growth chart, and because they don't grow well, you know, their height will also not grow well. Those are the children will have poor IQ, right? So many times mother said, oh, my child is not doing good in math, my child is not doing, because they must not have gained good amount of weight, not only during womb, not only during pregnancy, but also in first few months of life. So this is a really good study that, you know, we read all the time in pediatrics. Okay, and also another thing is your IUGR. So, you know, a lot of time, I mean, in India we see a lot of low birth weight babies, right? So here what they found, that children who were born small for gestational age means, you know, for that term or preterm baby, that weight was not enough. Okay, for whatever gestational age baby was born. So here, if the baby was born, say, at around 35 weeks of gestation, 35 weeks is basically your premature baby, or later, they scored lower score on your neurodevelopmental assessment. Means they did not do well neurodevelopmentally. Okay, so it is important that basically, you know, children grow very well in the womb during pregnancy. Okay, this is another very good study where there was a critical period of brain growth and cognitive function. So this is what they found, is a brain growth during infancy, early childhood is more important than growth during fetal life in determining cognitive function. This means that even if child is born, say, small, you know, but if child has beautiful growth in first, say, 12 months, 18 months, then that we can basically rescue the child. Okay, so even you go in the field and you see children are born to 2.3 kg, 2.4 kg, but, you know, you focus on the breastfeeding skill, you focus on the complementary feed, and children do beautifully. So this was another very good study which was done. Now, timing of growth faltering is very, very important, okay? Because what we found, this is one study which was done. They basically took 700,000 children, okay, from 0 to 6 years of age. And they took this data from 57 different countries. Look at this huge study, and very recent, 2018. Right, and what they found, that basically most linear growth faltering, linear growth means height, and the wasting, which is your acute malnutrition, it takes place prior to 23 months of age. Means most of your malnutrition, undernutrition takes place in 1,000 days. Okay, so here is the growth, here's a chart that they shown in their publication. So here, this is your boys. So these are your boys, okay? This is your mean, zero is mean. Most of the 50% children should be over here, okay? But here, as you see, this is your 0 month, 6 months, 12 months, 18 months. Do you see how boys, and this is your height, okay? Your height for age. So your Z score. So look at how children are growing, going down in 18 months, right? These are boys and these are girls. So girls are not so small to begin with, but basically they fall, right? Boys fall definitely much more, and then by 60 months, they are pretty much equal, right? So girls have advantage in the beginning. Now this is your weight for height, means this is your SAM, ma'am, your acute malnutrition, right? So here, this is your boys, this is your mean zero, Okay, so children overall in 57 different countries, children are not bad to begin with, but look at this, how badly they fall, right? And then they come up. So everything, whenever you see it, this growth faltering occurs in first 24 months, and generally wasting occurs much early on. That means children are not gaining weight. So in first year of age, look at this, in first year of age, children are not growing well, you know, they are not putting on weight, and eventually they become stunted also. Right. So what happens to all these children who are not growing well? They poor nutrition will lead to stunting. They will become short. OK, so if you're thinking that, you know, oh, my God, this child is so short. And if you see them at 3 years of age, 4 years of age, the stunting is irreversible. So it's irreversible if you don't tackle it within 1 year. OK, in my experience, if child came to me after 6 months of age, I could not do much about the stunting part, really. I had to bring those children up or a reversal of stunting. I could do it just if they came before 6 months of age. So that first 6 months is extremely important, okay? As they were losing height, they were also losing IQ, okay? So there is a loss of IQ, which is very, very detrimental to child's life, right? Then what happens to stunting? When you are stunted, you will be stunted as an adult, right? And if you're a woman, and if you're only 5 feet tall, then you will be basically passing on the stunting, you know, stunted girl child at 2 will give birth to a low birth weight baby. So your risk of getting a low birth weight baby is very high, okay, if you're stunted, okay? So you basically, you're passing on that, you know, yeah, that I wouldn't call it gene, but epigenetic expression to the child, okay? And then that stunted child has a very high risk of developing metabolic syndrome later on, okay? So you don't want the child to develop blood pressure, diabetes, so then you work on them in first 1,000 days and, you know, of course, continue on, and the children will not develop metabolic syndrome, okay? And sometimes it takes about 2 to 3 generations to combat stunting. So suppose child is stunted, mother is stunted, grandmother is stunted, so that girl child, it may take maybe 1 or 2 generation for the child to become 5'8", 5'9". I'm talking about a girl child, okay? And we have a lot of cases now, the children are really, girls are very tall even in India, okay? And but that takes 2-3 generation of good nutrition, okay? So there is this journalist, Mr. Roger Thoreau. He was in India and he did a lot of study, you know, on malnutrition. His beautiful paper, you guys must read it. And he wrote a beautiful, he quoted this, he wrote that if you want to improve the future, to truly improve the world, we have 1,000 days to do it. Mother by mother, child by child, for what happens in those 1,000 days through pregnancy to second birthday, it determines to a large extent the course of child's life, his, her ability to grow, learn, work, succeed, and by extension, the long-term health, stability, and prosperity of society in which the child lives. Okay, so it's, if you want to improve the world, you can't leave a single child and single mother. Okay, if you want a beautiful world where no child is malnourished, you have to basically go and help each and every mother who comes to your door, okay? Or you have to go to her door.
So I'm sure you understood the importance of first 1,000 days and how if first 1,000 days are not taken care of, then child will go into stunting and, you know, wasting and also underweight. So, and of course, brain development is so important because it's very rapidly growing during first 1,000 days, and also the physical growth, you know. So now we will start with our tutorials. So thank you.